Hi guys, I'm David with MediaUnlock.net, and today we're going to be talking about the Comica CVM-WM300 wireless lav system. Now, let's kind of walk through what we're going to be going over in this video today. One is what comes in the system, how well does the system work, and of course, we're going to do some audio tests with my more expensive Sony wireless lav system that I use to see how well it stacks up against it. Now, this system runs about $400 to $450 on Amazon, and as always, there will be a link to a card right here and a link at the end of the video if you want to check it out and purchase it. Now, let's take a look at what's inside and go through some of the specs and what I do and don't like about this system. One of the things I really do like is that it comes in a nice plastic case that protects it, therefore allowing you to do easy travel. Now, of course, you can take everything out if you need to downsize so that you can fit into a bag with the rest of your camera equipment. So you get a manual right here, which honestly, I do not need. The system is pretty self-explanatory as far as how the menu system works, and it works very well. They're very well made. They're the type of metal they use, it is a little bit heavier, so that you do feel like that the system actually has some heft to it, and it does a good job of probably being dropped and adding protection to the system itself. It doesn't feel like a cheap plastic system for some of the ones that are around $100 to $200. Now, this is your receiver right here. So you get a receiver, and then you get two transmitters. So as you notice, I have two transmitters. Now, it does put everything into one track, so you're not getting two separate tracks coming from the receiver and into the camera or your mixer. So the nice thing is, though, is that the system allows you to, let's say you're doing an interview with two people. Say I'm interviewing somebody like Bill, who's around here somewhere today.
No, I'm not.
And we're having an interview back and forth. This system would allow both of us to put on the lav, and it would go right into the receiver. You get your 1/8 inch. Well, you get your actual microphone that plugs into your lav system. 1/8 inch to go into your camera, DSLR, mirrorless camera, even a mixer that uses it, that uses a 1/8 inch. You get a little wind filter. Actually, some of this stuff I still haven't opened, so you get to see me open it here. But you get a nice little wind filter here that would go on top of your mic. So if it's nice and windy outside, that's gonna cut down on that noise. You get recharging. You get your charging cords here. Now, the nice thing is the system does say that they'll get about 10 hours of straight use if it's at full battery power. I find you get about 8.5 to 9 hours of straight use before you need to start recharging. Now, for some people, that can be a little bit frustrating, especially if, like myself, I always have a bag of batteries in my bag. So, like, when my lavs go down, I can just change out the batteries and I don't have to worry about that. Where when these go down, you've got to recharge them, unfortunately, before you can start recording again, start capturing sound. But again, if you're shooting for more than 9 hours straight, you need to have another plan in place.
If I'm doing it, I want a raise.
Yeah. All right, Bill, you and your raises. I'll give you a raise because I don't pay you anything right now anyways. So you can have a raise from nothing to nothing.
We gotta talk about that later.
You have another 1/8 inch. This is another microphone. And then the other really nice thing that it has for people that do have a mixer, which is how we're going to actually be testing the audio between the Sony and the Comica system, is your XLR. So this will plug from your receiver into, let's say, mixer. And I find that XLR does have a little bit higher quality. And then over here you have these little belt clips, and they're really easy to put on. You just take a system here, and there's a hole on each side, and it just goes from one hole to the other, and now you can clip it right onto your belt, your pants, whatever you need to do. So that is everything that actually comes inside the actual case. And let's go over some of the specs, and then let's actually test the audio out with my Sony system and see which one you guys think sounds better. Now again, you're getting a really nice UHF system for under $500, and you're getting two. So a lot of systems, like the Sennheiser systems, they're $600-$800 for just this. So you're getting a second transmitter, so you're able to capture twice the audio. So they say that it has around a 400 feet range. It's a little bit less than that, and around 200 feet if there is obstruction. So if there's walls or something in the way, it claims around 250 feet. I have not actually tested to see what that range really is, but it will go through some stuff that, you know, walls and some stuff that could get in your way. So I definitely know that I can get at least 20 to 30, 40, 50 feet away comfortably, and that's as far out as I've tested it. Again, I said it, they claim a 10-hour battery life. I've found that it gets about 8.5 to 9 hours. It does have real-time monitoring, so as the audio is coming into the system, you can actually physically see the real-time monitoring. And you can plug in an audio, some like headphones on the top, so you can actually listen to see what it sounds like. If I'm going out of a mixer or I'm going out of my camera, that's what I generally use for my audio monitoring, not this system itself, because I actually think that you get a better monitoring if you're actually monitoring the system it is actually going into. Metal construction, which I really, really like. Now, one thing that I have noticed, and we'll actually test that out so you guys can hear it, is that the audio does change. So let's just say I've just got a transmitter and a receiver right here, and I'm just using one system. And then I say, oh, I got an interview coming up. I need two people on it. So the second I turn the second system on, the audio does change a little bit and it gets a little bit quieter. And I'll actually do a test so you guys can hear the difference from just these two working to where we're using the whole entire system. We're using both transmitters and one receiver. The audio does change when you do that. Now, it doesn't affect the quality, but you're just going to have to readjust the audio levels and a few other settings maybe to make sure the audio comes out clearly. And that's kind of the walkthrough, kind of what I know about the system. Another thing that I really, really like about it is that I can manually change the actual output levels in here. So let's say I have a camera that doesn't physically allow me to change the out, like it, that you plug in the system into a camera and the camera itself does not allow me to change the audio levels. So whatever's coming out of here is what the camera's capturing. Well, I can actually control that in the system itself. And I really, really like that. So now I think it is time to actually do a little testing. Again, we're going to set up the system with the Sony and the Comacam, and we're going to see which system actually sounds better, and we'll bounce back and forth. I'll probably just be reading a book, and so you guys can get a little bit of an idea of which sounds better. The Sony, in my experience, is probably going to sound a little bit better, but it is also a more expensive system. For the amount of money that you're going to actually pay for this system, it's at a pretty good price level for the market. So let's test out some audio. Right now we are listening to the Sony wireless lav system, the UTX-B2, and we will switch over to the Comacam here in a minute. I'm using an external audio recorder, so the audio should be coming in as clean as possible, and I'm going to be setting both receivers to pretty much the same setting so that we should be getting the same level of audio quality between the two so we can actually hear the difference. So like I said, we're starting out with Sony. We are going to read out of Walks to the Paradise Garden, a low-down Southern Odyssey, written by Jonathan Williams, and in Guy Mendez, a local Lexington photographer, well-known throughout the world, did a lot of this photography. And what they did is they just went around and kind of met these different artists that really weren't well known, that were kind of obscure, and made this book on, Guy Mendez took the pictures and then Jonathan Williams wrote their story. So we'll just kind of pick a random page and I'll pretty much reread the same page over again with the Comica so you guys can hear the difference. So let's find an interesting page here. The still almost unknown Leroy Person, 1907 to 1985. The late Robert Lynch of Redbird Cabin, Enfield, North Carolina, was the man who discovered Leroy Persons. Robert Rabbit Lynch was an outsider, if there ever was one. Being part Indian, part black, part white, and gay to boot, could hardly have been the easiest lifestyle in the rural country of north of Rocky Mountain, North Carolina. He died several years ago, much too soon, in the manner of many gay men in the 1980s. His remarkable collection is intact, having been acquired by North Carolina Wesleyan College. There are over 200 examples of Leroy Persons to be seen there. And again, you guys can see what the artwork works like. So now you guys have heard a little bit audio from the Sony, from the Comica. We're still recording on the Comica right now. And I think for the money, it's a really solid system if you're looking for a wireless lav system. There are other options out there. There are definitely cheaper options out there. You can get a decent system for around $100 on Amazon. But if you're really looking to have something that you can use professionally, you know, if you're doing a lot of amateur stuff, YouTube videos, you're not making much money yet doing that, I could see you using a cheaper system, but if you are actually doing professional work and you need a solid lav system, I would look at the Comica system. I think it's really good. It's really solid, well made. And the audio is really actually pretty good for the system. And you know, you guys can make your decision if you think the Sony system may sound a little bit better than the Comica. Honestly, after listening to these, I think that it's actually a very close match on which one actually produces a better audio file. So, as always, guys, there's going to be a link at the end. There's a card up here. If you guys want to hit that, go check it out. Because if you guys do purchase it, we do get a little commission here that keeps this channel going. And yeah, we're really happy with it. One of the other nice things, again, is that case that it comes with, making it very portable, very easy to keep everything in one place. And as always, guys, we'll catch you next time. You guys have made it this far. If you want to check out our newest video, it will be right here. If you want to check out the product, it will be down here. If you do happen to click on it and purchase it, it does give us a little bit of commission, and that helps me a lot keep making these videos. And of course, guys, right down below, go and leave a comment, hit that subscribe button, follow along. We'll catch you next time.